is not available to answer questions because he is in a taxi about to visit the hospital.
When we contacted the cowboy, he denied his work was substandard. But since filming, the couple have received no more of the promised £50 payments. Coming up, I can't wait to see Dawn and Andrew's reaction when I reveal their transformed home. Dawn and Andrew Hendrickson's renovations turned to ruin when their trusted cowboy took their cash and never returned. They paid $9,000 but didn't receive their kitchen, flooring or door. Worse still, the work that had been done was dodgy and dangerous. Their dream of a beautiful home fit for a future family was in tatters. But we brought in the good guys, who've been hard at it, fixing the endless builder blunders in the bathroom, kitchen and exterior of the house. They've already stripped out that rotten kitchen and removed the plaster back to the brickwork. They're dealing with those disgusting damp problems once and for all.
You can see on the floor and on the wall and even the marks just how damp it's been behind the units.
While the work is progressing, the Hendricksons have moved in with Dawn's mum. Their anticipation is building.
You can't not to go and peek.
We will. I got 3 o'clock in the morning, just sat there talking about it.
I said it felt like, you know, when you go on holiday and you've got that little bit of nerves about going, but you're excited about getting there. That's how it felt.
Well, they'll have to be patient. Our guys are still hard at it. They fixed the leaky bathroom pipes from below and bricked up that kitchen wall where the cowboy had left a door to nowhere. And in the front room, they discovered the cause of all that dingy damp.
We took off the plasterboard and a lightweight plaster that's underneath, and this is now what we're left with. You can see all the damp on the brickwork where it's all going to come through. To tell them I've cured the damp problem in the front, it's just a blatant lie.
There's still a lot to
we get it done and get these kids back in their house as soon as we can.
This house of horrors will soon be a thing of the past. Dawn and Andrew are chipping in too to make sure that jobs are good.
I did have a few nightmares that everything's still gone wrong, but it's just going to be, it's going to be so nice to know that it's done properly and to know that you don't have to worry about it.
I just can't wait to get home.
I can't wait to see the final result either. It's been a few weeks in coming, but at last the work is over. And it's time for me to take a sneaky peek. Well, I'll tell you something. I did not expect that. This wasn't in the remit, by the way. The whole of this fascia at the front has actually been repainted. Look at that. Let's take a look inside.
State it was in before, it's in such a mess. I'm looking at it now, that's just amazing. The steps in place, you've not got a huge step.
We've removed that dodgy drop by adding an extra step. And with the electric sorted, the damp addressed, and the walls retiled and painted, it couldn't get much hotter in this kitchen.
It just looks like a fully functioning kitchen. This is going to be a massive surprise to them.
This room looks amazing, but what's happened outside to that troublesome rear wall?
Again, this has all been painted out here. Do you remember before, that was just all bricked up, it was just a complete mess, so that's all been done, and they've painted as well, so they've done reparation work where I was peeling that render off. Obviously they've taken it back where all the loose stuff was, and then painted it over with a proper exterior paint. Looks totally different. New window, of course, as well. Magic little job this is.
And it's not just this wall that's been painted. They've done the whole back of the house.
I mean, to be fair, just that lick of paint makes such a massive difference from out here. I'm staggered with it.
But the good guys didn't stop there. They fitted new hallway flooring, sorted the damp below the living room window, and upstairs in the bathroom, they've replaced the bodge job sealant around the bath and shower. This transformation is stunning. There's a man I need to thank.
Hey,
I'm
finishing touches.
Yeah,
I like it.
Just a bit of a different one.
First of all, walking into the house, all the outside of the property's been painted. And then, as you're coming inside now, the hallway, is that new laminate floor?
Yeah, we're going to put new laminate floor down because we have to renew the gas main as well.
What was that?
It was a gas leak, so we've cured, that's been cured.
I left it, it was a right mess. You've done an absolute stunning job for us. You should be proud of yourself.
Oh,
why don't you carry on sorting that pipe out?
Oh, hi, mate.
All right, mate. Cheers. I can't wait to show Dawn and Andrew their beautiful home. Now then, I've asked the taxi driver to drop Dawn and Andrew off down the road, so I've got a long walk ahead of me, a bit of exercise. Yes, I know I need it.
They've been living with Dawn's mum for the last couple of weeks, so they're going to be stunned by the work.
We're going to have to stop meeting like this. How are you, Andrew? How are you, lovely?
You're
all right, you're excited.
I am, yeah.
Now, what are you hoping for?
A safe home?
Yes, a safe home.
Electric sorted?
Yeah.
Indeed.
Yeah. Well, are you suitably excited?
Very much so, yeah.
Come on. Outside, okay. Now it's time for the big boy. Inside, okay. You ready?
Yeah.
Fine. And just through the door, the first surprise. Now there's something you'll notice straight away. You had a problem with the gas. There was a gas leak, so that had to be all repiped to make it safe. Now the thing is, I'm building up slowly because we're about to go check out the kitchen.
Lovely, isn't it? And it's so much more space.
Look at all the cupboards.
They're like the tiles.
Oh, look at the lights.
How will this change your life now?
It's going to be a lot safer, isn't it? I'm guessing that way as well.
All the electrics have been sorted out. Bare cables are banished and new sockets fitted. As for that damp problem, all of the fittings with the bath underneath,
yeah.
It was the waste pipe that was the problem. It was actually put on, twisted and cross-threaded.
Yeah.
So it was just tipping out the waste from the bath, and that's what was causing the leak. And you enjoy it, see what it's all about. And remember that door that wasn't a door?
You had a doorway to nowhere. That's gone. It's gone. That looks like a completely different kitchen.
Is sure this is our house?
This is your house. We've installed all their mud ponds. Cooker, an extractor fan and a tumble dryer. And they'll no longer be dodging damp as they have new cupboards to store their food in. The transformation is just incredible.
He's really done a great job for us, haven't you?
Well, we like to think so. This is a special kitchen. But outside, I have a few other surprises in store.
We literally cannot form a sentence.
It changed your life.
A big change to life.
Bigger than this transformation is the impact it will have in the days to come.
I hope you have a fantastic future today. You deserve it.
Oh well, can't wait. We can start our
family. And the cowboy had taken money for a kitchen he never delivered. They were out of cash and out of luck.
It's been very hard for me. Panic attacks, constantly not sleeping.
But this incredible transformation really is life-changing, and it's proof there are great builders out there. Dawn and Andrew are thrilled, and I reckon Mum Norma will be too.
Oh,
them hard. But I've got a message for all cowboy builders out there. Look over your shoulder, because we're right behind you. If you've had a problem with builders and you would like to tell your story on Cowboy Trap, then please call us on 0207 258 6724. Standard geographic charges apply.
What's the series tonight at 9? Charles Hanson and Anita Manning, the experts today for Bargain Hunt, and that's after the news headlines. Next.
Marty, welcome to Wales.
You've been quite the day to arrive. Everything's happening.
I think he's going to speak to us.
Protect us from the evil that men do.
If you refuse to be vaccinated, then I cannot allow you to work amongst the sick.
You're putting people's lives at risk.
Even after everything you've witnessed with your own eyes, you still believe you're right.
I am right about this. I'm a doctor.
Indian doctor. Next Monday at 2:15 on BBC One and BBC One HD. Headlines now on BBC One and BBC One HD with Sophie Weymouth.
Good afternoon. Water shortages in parts of England are being discussed at a special meeting hosted by the Environment Secretary Caroline Spelman. Large areas of the country have had very little rain this winter. There are warnings of the worst water shortages in more than 30 years. Bonus payments worth £2 million have been clawed back from around 10 current and former executives. Banking group. It follows the mis-selling of payment protection insurance. Several members of a group in Alfred Middle School in Worcestershire are still in hospital in France after their coach crashed. Tributes have been paid to Peter Lippington, the teacher who died. Police are continuing to question a man about the murders of Reverend John Sullard in Gloucestershire last week and 77-year-old Betty Yates in Worcestershire in January. 47-year-old Stephen Farrell was arrested yesterday. David Cameron is meeting healthcare professionals today to push the case for the government's proposed changes to the health service in England. Some opponents of the plans have complained that they haven't been invited. And the weather, there'll be wind and rain in northern parts with drier in the south. That's it for the latest here at 1 o'clock.
Little treasures at Alexandra Palace for Bargain Hunt. Next.